Yep.
Look at them just coming up there.
1, 2, 3. Watch out for that hook that's coming up there. Look out.
The episode that you're about to watch, along with many hundreds more full episodes and videos to come, filmed all around the world with all different kinds of species, are all going to be available for you to watch right here for free, thanks to our mates at ITM. So enjoy.
Alaska is one of the world's great wilderness frontiers. To get there from New Zealand, we had to travel to the other side of the world, and still we had to make the last leg of our long journey by float plane. And while in the air, as far as we could see, mountains, forest, and ice dominated the vast Alaskan landscape. Along the steep sides of the cliffs, the cold ocean filled the deep inlets that had been carved out by ancient glaciers. This cold water is home to the world's greatest salmon fishery.
And pretty much with every cast, you'll catch one of these guys.
And that is a fine fish.
And also home to the bizarre looking halibut.
Call them what you want, that there is just a giant flounder.
We got more than we bargained for with halibut.
Ooh, they can run. I might have picked a bit of a fight here.
Turns out that these giant flounders are actually extremely powerful, and they have a reputation for destroying boats when they're brought aboard, so the local anglers don't take any chances.
Guys do carry guns to shoot these halibut, right?
The Pacific halibut is a bottom dweller found mainly in the cool North Pacific waters. Anglers will encounter them at an average size of around 10 kilograms, but they have been reported up to 600 pounds, which is over 250 kilograms. At this size, they possess almost unstoppable power.
This reel spun as fast as it could go with the drag, and it snapped right off.
But he doesn't want a live, fully able halibut in that boat with him. No. He's got to be disabled.
If you treat him bad, he's going to take you down.
Yeah, he's going to take a ride. It'll be fun to watch.
Here, the local American anglers seem to be fearful of the halibut, so I thought I'd go out and catch one on a hand line from a small raft, just to raise a few eyebrows. But first, we'd better go out into this stunning Alaskan wilderness to find some halibut and see what all the fuss is about.
Well, it is another stunning Alaskan morning. You know, we're just going to do a little bit of drift fishing this morning. I've got Neil with me, good southern man. Here we are fishing. I'm fishing with a lure this time. Neil's stuck with the baits that have served him so well, and let's see if we can try and catch us some halibut, hopefully on a lure.
Yep.
He whacked into it again.
Geez, I tell you what, they put up a stubborn resistance.
I'm not going to call the size of them because obviously lighter tackle, that sinker, they can fight a bit more.
Now that's a decent fighting fish. Now you'd look at those halibut and you'd think flounder, something benign. Certainly if you got one on the old hand line, it would tow you around. I'll give that a go at some stage, I think.
They seem to give up the ghost just as they get to the surface.
Sort of thing they were telling us to look out for, but obviously when they're bigger. That one there, he's getting a bit bigger. But, yeah, look at that. That's the lure that he slammed into. So they're a predatory fish, and they obviously are. Just going to pop that lure out and get him back in there. I'm looking forward to getting a real big one on a lure, the fight that I got out of that thing. Ain't he a beauty? He's on his way. He's going home. Going home.
Well done.
It's great just to be fishing for halibut in this stunning location, surrounded by humpback whales and hauling in some tasty halibut. But we still need to find some bigger halibut to get a first-hand experience of what these awesome fish are capable of. Our Kiwi mates Paul and Justin are fishing nearby and have hooked up to something big. So we're going to go and check it out.
Well, Justin's hooked into a real good one here. We've come over to check it out. I'm going to jump on board and see if I can get into a bit of a swim with it.
Ethan coming up, mate. You're doing well, mate. Nice smooth technique. Justin's got his technique down. All that practice on blue cod down in Southland.
Look at him just coming up there. Now, this is when they're normally benign, and we've been warned about this. When they first come up, they're normally pretty relaxed. It's once that shark hook gets into them, that's when they can really light up. So I'm a little bit anxious. I mean, I'm trying to get a little bit of underwater footage of them here, but my heart's pounding, and really all I want to do is secure the fish. Now, I'm not a cameraman anymore, I'm a fisherman. Okay, we're going to do the old American style, Alaskan style shark hook trick on them. Come on up, just even one up. And they say when they hit the surface, their mouth opens up. And what I need is for him to open his mouth. But if he rolls over this way, it'll be good. Come on, buddy. Just a little bit further, mate. A little bit further. Okay, and that's what we expected he was going to do. It's going to go a little bit crazy on us. Geez, now, this is why they said that I'd be mad to do this out of a raft. Which I'm going to try and head out and do tomorrow. And on second thoughts, I might just stay in the big boat tomorrow. Come on. Oh, come on, Hal. Jeez, man. Okay, you think we try and get him in the boat? They kind of said leave him there for 10 minutes to tire out, but I'd much rather he was in here. One, two, three, watch out for that hook when he comes in, man. Look out, dude. Watch out for that hook, man. Holy hell. Now, the old Inuit Indian said, rub its belly and he'll come down. Rub his belly. You can see he's really lassoed himself up there. I'm very wary of that big old shark hook there. So you can use that as a weapon against me. Look at that. That's one heck of a flounder.
Yeah, ain't it?
Sweet. Well done, man. That fish there is, as they would say over here, that's a trip maker, man.
Oh, yeah.
Our first day out fishing in Alaska has given us a taste of these stunning surroundings, the wildlife, and of course, the fishing. But we also got a small sample of the power and ferocity of the halibut. But it wasn't until we got back to Doc Warner's lodge where the local fishermen began to tell us of a great halibut that could never be caught. A fearsome halibut known only as Angry Hal.
Talked to him out there at Mary's Flat.
Yeah.
And he towed us all the way back to the dock before he got off.
Do you remember seeing him, Dave?
No. It's pretty tough to see Angry Hal. He swims at about 300 feet. That towed us through the water at 300 feet.
We put two fishing poles on two lines on one hook and had Hal hooked at one point. And Hal just pulled until we got all the way back. And the line snapped, didn't it, Dave?
Yep. Had to have been him.
We've heard him, though.
You've heard him?
Oh, yeah, you've heard him. You've heard him. You heard those whales out there today?
Yeah.
They're quiet compared to Angry Hal.
Yeah, I've heard that the noise that the whales are making are warning all the other whales that Hal's in the area.
It could be, but I'll tell you, you hold on when you hear that stuff.
Yeah.
He'll grab onto you.
What does it sound like? Can you make that audible for us? Could you just make that noise?
I don't like to. It scares me.
You never want to make him angry. Because you know what? If you treat him bad, he's going to take you down.
Any fisherman that thinks he can catch Angry Hal, and he's got fear in his soul, is the legend true?
And I witnessed with my own eyes as this reel spun as fast as it could go with the drag, and it snapped right off, and Angry Hal was gone.
As soon as it took the line, I yelled to Rich, I said, cut the line, and I said, it's Angry Hal, and he says, no, let him run, we'll catch him, we can get him. I didn't want to. I increased the drag on the rod, and then it kept spinning, so I put both thumbs down. It was rubbing right through my gloves.
You know why that's a good thing? Because while you think you've hooked Angry Hal, he's actually hooked you.
Yeah, and I was fearful. I was afraid. But Rich said, no, we can take him. And I think that's why he snapped the line.
Do you have any fear in your soul?
Yeah, I do. Sometimes I do, yeah.
I don't think we're up to it. I mean, these are all hardened Alaskan fishermen. Mm-hmm. We've come up from little old New Zealand. I mean, I catch marlin with my hands, and I'm scared. Looking around all you people, all so honest, truth and integrity in your eyes. He's out there. Just wait. I'm coming to get you, pal. I'm coming to get you.
The cameraman, reporter from NBC here, following some of our fishing over here.
You know, there actually is a possibility that you could get some big fish into that little bitty raft of yours and be seriously injured.
You notice my tackle? It's hardly conventional.
Yo, got him on!
Well, I hope you're enjoying this episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
Well, this morning, back in the same area, it's a little bit different sort of looking day. I mean, it changes by the hour, let alone the day here in Alaska, the weather. It's remarkable, and we're still setting up, getting microphones and stuff ready, and Paul throws out a sly bait, and we've got a fish, so we're here to make a fishing show, so we better film it.
I fell to there, what's it?
Oh, yeah. Swing him on over.
Here we have our halibut.
They really seem a little bit benign, don't they? They hardly seem like this dangerous man killer, breaker of legs, wrecker of boats. Just doesn't he seem a cutie? You just got to treat him right, and they'll be nice for you. And away he goes. Go tell your big bad granddaddy I'm coming after him. Now, our style of stunt fishing has created a little bit of attention in this part of the world. We've got a cameraman, reporter from NBC here, following some of our fishing over here. They kind of think it could be a little bit dangerous. I mean, I had, to be fair, heard about halibut all the way from New Zealand, and a big dangerous fish, particularly one that I've never caught before in a place that I've never been to before. To me, that's like a red flag to a bull. I had to come here and try it, and well, seems these guys have heard of my antics, and we're also lucky today to have Kelly with us from Doc Warner's, and we're going to make the most of his local knowledge, because anywhere you go when you're fishing, you just can't beat local knowledge. We've had a day and a half fishing here. We've caught a few, but we're in the right area today, Kelly?
I think so.
Yeah?
Halibut fishing is... one day you're a really good fisherman, and the next day you're searching. But we've caught a lot of halibut here this summer.
There's a legendary fisherman around here by the name of Wild Bill. Lived up in the hills. He'd fight bear with his hands for 6 months in training to catch Angry Hal. Sad to say, he was no match for Angry Hal. Some seen his boat getting pulled right under. We're here today to see if the legend's true. Track down Angry Hal. He's out there. I can smell him.
You know, there actually is a possibility that you could get some big fish into that little bitty raft of yours and be seriously injured. There are stories that float around of people who have lashed themselves to the mast of their fishing boat and brought on halibut in excess of 400 pounds, and you know, without shooting them or anything like that, and a fish starts flopping around and literally trashes the boat and squashed the guy against the mast where he had tied himself, and they found him dead, tied to the mast, and the halibut in the bottom of the boat.
Dead?
dead.
Guys do carry guns to shoot these halibut, right?
Yes, people that, you know, a lot of fishermen around here carry little 410s or handguns, you know, little small shotguns and things to shoot halibut before they bring them in their boat to quiet them down a bit, you know, because they thrash around quite substantially when you bring them on board.
All right, let's go find one. Now, you notice my tackle is hardly conventional. I would have liked to have brought my electric fence reel, which is what I used to catch the marlin on a handline, which was like the birth of stunt fishing, if you like. But it didn't pack in my suitcase, so I've gone for $9. I've got my plastic handline, and I figure that it should be up to the job, if I'm up to it, of catching a big old giant halibut. And I'm hopping into my craft here, which first time aboard. Seems like it'll do the job, and I mean, I guess even a 60 or 80 pound halibut's gonna take up the best part of this, so I'm really looking forward to it. Starting to feel the old butterfly starting to amp up there. This could be the real thing. Yeehaw! We take our safety very seriously on the fishing show. We don't cut any corners, so given that I'm in a small vessel and a fish that they say could drag me overboard, although I've never heard of a flounder hurting anyone, still, can't be too careful. I guess the theory is exactly the same as what we were using yesterday when we were fishing out here. Fresh baits, we've got our really bizarre looking halibut rigs we got here. The only difference is I've got it on a hand line, so it's all pretty low key really. The only difference is I'm fishing from a raft, and if I get a big one, well, the way these guys are talking, it could be something pretty special, but there's only one way to find out, I suppose. I've never used one of these hand lines before either. First time.
When you get a halibut on, it's like someone has a hold of the end of the rod and they're trying to pull you out of the boat. That's what it feels like. It's like they're trying to just pull you out of the boat. So I can just imagine what it's going to be like in that little craft you're in.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
We're going to see Matt's feet on top of the water. He'll be head down hanging onto the handline.
Come on, we're only talking about oversized flounder here.
Now, we're shooting for the fences here. Matt thinks he's gonna catch a 300 pound halibut, but you gotta understand, if he catches a 50 pound halibut in that boat, it's gonna tow him around the bay. So this is gonna be pretty exciting, I think, in my opinion. We'll see what happens.
Oh, hello, I've got something. Yo, got him on! I don't think it's angry hal, but it's something. One thing I kind of hadn't thought about is what I'm going to do with all my loose line. I think the method I'm going to use is the bird nest technique, where it's just going to tangle up in the boat. So it's just where to move to, so I don't tangle up all the line around my feet. I might just move to the other end of the raft here. It's hard for me to get a gauge on the size of this fish that I got on here, because I'm so used to using a fishing rod. I mean, this could even be a little rock cod or rockfish that they call them here. It's, you know, I've really got nothing to compare it to. I mean, the last fish I caught on a hand line was a giant bluefin tuna, you know, 250 kilo sort of job. And all I can tell you is it's a lot easier than that. But, I mean, halibut on a hand line out of a raft, it's, I know I'm stretching it, but we are in the United States, the land of hype. The land of hype and publicity. And I mean, I can't just go doing it traditional style when I've got a fully fledged news reporter with us, can I? I sincerely hope, I know you think I'm crazy, I sincerely hope I do get a 200 pounder. Oh, hello. Look at this fella here. He's not a bad one. Okay, relax, buddy.
So you reckon one of these guys, you'd normally shoot him, like if he was a big one. So you get him alongside, shoot him, bring him on board. Well, this one here, what do you reckon, Kelly? That would be a keeper, would it?
The fishing game has no size restrictions at all, but we try to throw back anything shorter than 30 inches.
I mean, I can only take so much on the aeroplane back to New Zealand with me. And, you know, we've got a bit of a saying back at home called, you know, fish for tomorrow. Okay. So we only take enough to eat, and already, probably, with our fish we caught yesterday, we've probably just about got enough to eat. So I think I've just answered my own question. I'm going to let him go. That is awesome. I mean, that is, I mean, some would say that was an ugly fish. I reckon it's awesome. They're solid, so much weight to them. Obviously, they swim differently, you know, with a dolphin style kick. And that's what I'm going to see right now as I let this little baby go. You're going home, back to your home. Go tell your great grandmother.
Well, we've broken the ice. Now we can catch a bigger one.
Yep. He's nearby.
Next week, the hunt for Angry Hal continues.
I don't know how qualified he is to disable a halibut.
Despite warnings from the local Alaskan fishermen of the extreme danger he faces, Matt continues on his mission to catch a halibut from his small raft.
You treat him bad, he's gonna take you down.
Not only does he not take heed of the warnings, he mocks the mighty halibut.
Come on, we're only talking about oversized flounder here.
But it's no ordinary fish that Matt is about to encounter. Alaskan halibut have seriously injured and even killed men. Angry Hal is the most fearsome of all halibut. Taking on Angry Hal with a hand line from a small raft is suicidal, but this Kiwi guy might just be crazy enough to do it. Will he hook Angry Hal? Will he survive? Find out next week on The Hunt for Angry Hal.
We hope you enjoyed this episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.